Sasha, our bus driver, he will bring us safely to Rothenburg and from there back to Wurzburg, where we see the palace and then back to the ship. My name is Alexander. I will be your guide today. I will give a little talk on this bus. I will show you around in this medieval town of Rothenburg, and I will later give a tour of the palace in Wurzburg, the residence palace, the city palace in Wurzburg. And today, at the moment, we have arrived in the city of Karlstadt, or the town of Karlstadt. Nach links, okay. Nach Wurzburg.
Also yeah, links.
Wurzburg. Okay. Durch Wurzburg.
Okay.
All right. Just giving some hints to our driver. we have arrived in Karlstadt. And Karlstadt is just a very small town, as you can see. It is pretty historic. It traces its roots back to the year 928, actually. So this town is more than 1,000 years old. And it is named after the first German emperor, Karl der Große, Charlemagne, or Charlemagne, as you might know him. And he was formerly the king of the Franks, and then later he was by the Pope crowned to be the first German emperor, basically, to put it simply. And he is one of the reasons why the people living here in this region are very proud to be not Bavarians, but in fact Franconians. Because politically speaking, we are in one of the 16 federal states of Germany, the largest one in fact, being Bavaria. So politically, everybody living here is a Bavarian. But the locals a lot of times point out the similarity between the words Bavarian and Barbarian. They, Franconians, because they have been independent from Bavaria for approximately 200 years. And more importantly, in earlier times, Bavaria was just a very small fledgling duchy, and only in recent centuries became important. Formerly, this region of Franconia was much more important. Basically, the forefathers of the people living here today were not called Franconians, but Franks, and they were the predominant Germanic tribe that took over power from the Roman Empire, when the Roman Empire collapsed. Around the year 800 up until the year 1000 at least, Franconians would reign over parts of Spain, over modern-day France, Germany, northern Italy, and some parts of Eastern Europe even. And because of that, a lot of words actually go back to this tribe. For example, the word France, in German, France is called Frankreich, which means literally translated the realm of the Franks, of the Franconians. You might have heard the expression lingua franca, which is the language that everybody communicates in, the language that everybody speaks. And this is a Latin expression, and literally means the language of the Franks. Today, the lingua franca of the world is obviously English. Everybody communicates in English nowadays. Or you can all also say, for example, you are telling something frankly, like frankly speaking your mind, just telling the truth how it is. All of these go back to the forefathers of the people that are nowadays living here in this region. And this makes them quite proud of their history. More modern examples of famous Franconians would be, for example, Levi Strauss, the jeans designer. He was a Franconian immigrant, and you might know the Dallas Mavericks and the basketball teams, and also maybe their star player or former star player now that he is retired, Dirk Nowitzki. Dirk Nowitzki comes from the city of Wurzburg. He started playing for the local basketball team there, and in later years he went to play for the Dallas Mavericks. Today I would say he is the most famous son of the city, or at least the most popular one. Every time he returns from the States, there's a large celebration in the street. People trying to get streets named after him. Everybody is very proud of this famous son of the city of Würzburg. And in the political realm, for example, there is Henry Kissinger to be spoken of. Henry Kissinger, I hear some booing. Well, regardless what you think of his politics, he is from this region here, and he's obviously a pretty famous politician. He comes originally from the city Bad Kissingen. That's why he is called Kissinger. German Kissinger just means somebody being from Kissingen. And he emigrated when he was pretty young. So, let me keep that point until we reach Wurzburg, because obviously I am looking very much forward to telling you all about this region, the cities, their history, German culture and all the likes. But on the other hand side, I know that we have to spend the entire day together, and I don't want you to get fed up with my voice until we have even reached our first destination. So I will try to find a good balance between giving you all the information that you need, giving you all the highlights, but also not boring down on you with too many details and just swamping you. But obviously, always feel free to ask if any additional questions might arise.
One question. Yes, how long before we get to?
Obviously, a very important information would be how long our journey to Rothenburg takes. At this point, I would say 1 hour and 20 minutes approximately.
Eine von den großen Problemen. Das finde ich mal ganz gut. nee, das, also wenn das in der E-Mail stimmt, dann ist das ein anderer Platz.
Okay.
So, das hängt schon noch ein bisschen noch davon ab, wie es nachher dann, wo die halt einen Platz kriegen.
Nee, muss man dann später mal mit PG schreiben, oder? Muss ja. Man mit Leder schreiben, was er sagt.
Genau, das ist ein Fuß. Also, heute Mittag fahren die Busse für die Tour-Tour alle ab, also von da dann ab, wo das Schiff dann liegt. Hm? Das heißt, wenn du denen schreibst, wo die Mittagsbus fahren, dann musst du dann nachher noch hin. Schranke vorbeigeschossen. Das war also super eigentlich.
Dann sehe ich dann dort vor Ort. Thank you.
nearing the city of Wurzburg. On the right hand side, if you look out of the right windows, you can see on the hill the Festung Marienberg, the fortress Mary's Mountain, the local castle overlooking this. Overlooking the city of Wurzburg. Wurzburg is a city in this